chest. And I want you to finish it through this whole word. We'll be spending for about 48, 50 minutes straight on that word. So prepare yourselves. Prepare yourselves. Just in case you didn't see my Facebook page. E9, tomorrow, 10 to 4, you can get tested for the COVID-19. Black doctors are doing our people's for all people. But just in case you need to get tested, it's tomorrow at E9. Tabernacle Baptist Church. I want you guys to go get tested, save the world, so we can open our spinning studios, our salon spas, so I can get back to what used to be normal. Woo! I'm going to see you guys out there tomorrow just cheering on. I might take my class out there on Facebook Live, just give you some encouragement, a little exercise, 27 feet away from you, but you can hear me. God bless you. God bless you. I want everyone to stand if you can.
Hearing the word of God. I thought about this this morning.
Stand.
Somewhere in the White House, there's a root called the situation. There's a root that has stood up. Times of trouble, serious trouble, times of war, and times like this, such as a pandemic. In that world, commanders and leaders get together and they decide what orders to give to the field. And pass down orders to the commanders of how to make it through and how to get
how to make it through.
This morning, I thank God that he has this situation that stood up this morning. It's open and exactly. I don't know who's occupying that room in the White House, but I know he's
all right, we're going to have a seat. I want you to continue. Now we know we can stand. Now we know we're ready to work out. So I don't know about you guys. I'm prepared for this word coming. So I want you guys to reach in, reach down. And we're going to get started as our pastor comes to the mic. This is J.Louis, Felton of Mt.Airy Church of God in Christ. Spinners, 80 RPM, seated flat.
Further bless our hearts.
Now, as you write on this word,
this is what
as our bishop is speaking, I want you to remember, this is your bride. This is your word. If you want to stand, you can stand. If you want to sit, if you want to go on a flat road, when we're on that hill, turn it down. It's your bride. It's your word.
Than God allows him.
We're right, the whole word.
So we recognize that we live in this world. We are not of it, but we are in it. And as much as we're in it, we have to deal with that tightrope of tension between church and state. I firmly believe in separation of church and state, and we are separated, but because we are not divorced, God has a word for the state, even from the church.
I'm at 90 RPM, seated flat.
Since we're in the situation, why don't you place your burden before the Lord right now?
Now, right now, if you have anything, I want you to think about it.
The thing that
right now, everyone out there, put it out there. Let it go. At the end of this word, it will be gone.
You can give it to Jesus. Father, we thank you that we have the right to come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may find mercy and find grace to help us in this time of need. Thank you for anticipating this struggle. Thank you for your foreknowledge. You saw this in advance. And that is why you anchored us in your purpose and will. You have made us steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. We are encouraged. We feel your holy presence. We sense your power. We are aware that you're in this place, filling this house with your glory. We thank you for healing in that home this morning. We thank you for bringing peace in the midst of confusion. We thank you for settling our doubts and our fears. We thank you for speaking peace in the midst of our storm and even in the midst of selfish, short-sighted political leadership. Thank you for being the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings. The government is upon your shoulder. We live for you because you never fail. You promise never to leave us alone. Touch us now.
Come on.
We can't touch each other, but you can touch us, and we can touch you. We touch the hem of your garment by faith and touch you and feel the flow of the blood of Jesus Christ. And we thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your anointing.
Thank him out there.
So real.
Thank him.
Our souls today. We touch you. Thank you for the victory. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Now we're going to go off for a second and listen to this. Felton of the Mt.Airy Church of God in Christ. But now I need you to dig down Turn it down. Woo! Give me about 80.
Testify to something next to him. Tell him, I'm strong.
I'm stronger, Mark.
I'm wise.
I'm wiser, Mark.
I'm better.
I'm better out there.
Much better.
Much better.
When I look back.
When I look back to March 11th, when they closed me down,
I
didn't realize I could still be standing.
Woo!
I'm so much stronger. I am so much wiser. I'm going to get better out there, America. Because I made it through the storm. I'm making it. Ride with my gloves, but I know how to fight. I do know how to pray. Oh yeah. Woo! 70 RPMs. How's everybody else doing their workout? Are you doing your jumping jacks? Are you squatting? Woo! Come on. We got to get it in this morning. Woo, 70 RPMs, better seen it. We're climbing. Woo! You know what? Sometimes the spirit leads you somewhere. And I hear a word.
Chapter 1, verse 8.
from the third chapter of the book of Philippians, the 10th and 11th verses.
This is the word of the day.
And the power of his resurrection, and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death, if by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead. Colossians chapter 2, verses 12 through 15. Buried with him in baptism, wherein also he arisen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who had raised him from the dead. And you being dead in your sins, and the uncircumcision of your flesh, have he quickened together with him.
105 sinners.
All.
Hold steady.
Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us and contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them over all triumphant. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. But you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Let us reason together from this subject, a pilgrimage of power, Passover to Pentecost.
Got a couple more minutes, staying on this flat road.
Thanks be to God for this powerful connection, the writings of the Holy Spirit entrusted to the Apostle Paul in the books of Philippians and Colossians, and to Dr. Luke in the book of Acts. For each of them help us to negotiate the spiritual pilgrimage in which we are involved.
Woo!
But to say the pilgrimage of power,
hold on,
the Pentecost means that we are ready for what's next. The hymn says, each victory will help you another to win. Which is to say that we were victorious before, and we're going to be victorious again. Sunday, the Lord blessed us in a tremendous celebration inside and outside of this sanctuary as we engaged in the Resurrection Day worship. Certainly, we recognize that every Sunday is Resurrection Sunday.
Uh-oh.
Every day for a believer is Resurrection Day.
It'll burn.
We celebrated such a momentous and victorious celebration on Resurrection Sunday. What will you do next after you have won the victory? Different people interpret
two more minutes on this flat road.
Some people believe that the victory is a time to vote.
Make sure you're checking your posture. These are up, core is in. Your feet is face down, we're pressing.
But that's not how it works.
Work on your posture as you're on this flat road.
You have fought a bitter battle with sin, death, hell, and the grave. In this game fight, Jesus hit every last one of them. With sin, by being born immaculately conceived of the Holy Spirit to the Virgin Mary. To be dead simply by being born holy. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Jesus, by being born conceived of the Holy Spirit, did not inherit the penalty of death that you and I inherited. If we have been in a situation where, as Jesus does, you can escape that inheritance connection from the first Adam, then we too would have simply been born with the freedom of everlasting life. But Jesus
has been on this flat road.
Birth, different incarnation, a different manifestation.
Right with it.
I was born because biologically, when a man and woman come together, that is how our birth is effectuated. Jesus, however, was born not because a man loved the woman, but because God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not
give me 30 more seconds on this flat road.
The Holy Spirit is the one that fulfilled the prophecy of God in Genesis chapter 3:15, that the seed of the woman shall bruise the serpent's head, the seed of the serpent shall bruise his heel. Jesus Christ is the seed of the woman, in that as the prophecy went forth, a woman shall compass a man.
Woo!
To say that the Holy Spirit is
give me some more.
The
we're going to take it into a climb. Give me some resistance. Get to about 85.
For Christ.
Settle in. We're going to climb up this hill.
The Holy Spirit is the one that chooses what Jesus will look like, what he will speak like, what he will sound like.
Still a nice strong
physical package. The Holy Spirit is the one that makes that selection. The Holy Spirit is engaged in being used by the Father to select the blood type of Jesus. For the blood of Jesus is incorruptible. Because Jesus is conceived by the Holy Spirit, he does not inherit sin.
I'm at 2.5 hand position.
Because you
and
I were born in sin. We inherited a death. The wages of sin is death. Whether you commit sin or whether you inherit sin, whatever it is that got you
get your water when you need it.
Situation, death goes along with the package. But the Holy Spirit broke the cycle of death. The Holy Spirit intercepted.
Give me some more resistance.
Cycle so that
we're going to climb up this hill.
Pass on to
and a seated climb.
Sin was not passed on to Jesus. Because if he had been the
issue of Adam's body,
he would have inherited Adam's nature. But because he is the issue of Yahweh,
keep giving yourself resistance until you get to there. Your thresh, where you're pushing and burning.
Already defeated. All you gotta do now is defeat the grave and why we celebrate the resurrection every Sunday and every day, because we live in resurrection power. That's what Paul is talking about in Philippians chapter 3.
Pressing heavy, seated, climb.
Again, that's an expression of intimacy with Christ. And I want to know the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering.
Suffering
we need fellowship. When things are
2 minutes and 30 seconds.
When your eyes, when burdens get heavy, that's
press
the
for
time to have fellowship. That's when God binds us closer together. That's the reason why we are people and we are community.
Woo.
Because our sufferings have brought us together. We are the community of pain.
Woo.
And because we are the community of pain, we got pain in common.
Come
the
on.
Pain of lost loved ones. The pain of struggling.
If you want it a little more, just give yourself all your resistance you can bear. Press up for the last 2 minutes.
See
the crime. If you have to stand on it. Turn it.
In this country for 401 years, having been brought here forcibly in 1619, placed in abject poverty, subhuman conditions, we are the community of pain. If it were not for pain, we wouldn't be the community. It's not your skin color that makes you the community, not just your
press.
Language. It is not simply your culture or heritage, but pain has a way of
pain.
Together. When you're in pain, you need somebody to beguile your pain and
beguile
your joy. When you're in pain, you need somebody who is a burden bearer, a
burden
shadow. When you're in pain, you need to worship with somebody who recognizes that when we magnify the Lord, then his power becomes bigger to us.
1 minute!
Than our problems or our
press.
Problems. This is why worship is so important. Insignificant. It is the reason why we walk in authority. Because when God gives you his grace, then you realize you thrive in the midst of pain.
Oh, pain.
The fact
30 seconds.
Endure pain on the cross.
Whoa.
Cannot claim the heritage.
Why am I starting at this pain?
Because
it feels good.
Joy and pain.
Joy.
The first thing that you got to do is have a baptism into pain. Because Jesus says, if you will
turn it down,
take up your cross and
bring it up.
What is a cross for?
Bring it up.
Pain. It's for breaking down pride in self. It's for putting flesh in subjection to God.
Woo!
The cross is
there was some joy and pain.
Suffer with Christ. But you may know Christ in the fellowship of
suffering.
I know that there are a lot of so-called modern day or post-modern Christians who do not identify with the cross. For years, we've had churches that have built sanctuaries and
there's
no cross anywhere in it. We've got bourgeois, stuck-up, snobbish, nose in the air.
Have a seat.
We don't want to talk about pain.
Turn gear down.
You don't have problems religion. You don't get Woo. Sick religion. You need some kind of super believer religion.
Give
what
me
you say
95.
Now, the COVID-19 virus has struck in
we're going on a nice cool.
Don't you understand?
Freeze through this word.
How to deal with your pride.
Freeze through this word.
Still talk in the world of another. Still talk.
How y'all feel?
Crashing websites of states, dealing with a pandemic of pain.
If you just tuned in. Come on. We're listening to the word of J.Louis, Felton of Mt.Airy Church of God in Christ. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. My bishop. Come on. We're riding, me and my husband riding the whole word. We're not stopping. We got to stand on this word. We got to trust this word. Let's go. Let's go. Give me 100 RPMs. He still controls it. There you go. We're praising him just this morning. And ladies and gentlemen, wherever you're at, all over the world, praise him. Work it out. Work it out. Strong we are. Joy. Woo, 75 RPM. are spinners.
Give me about 90 RPM.
because there are some laws.
My late to light. Heavy word
to the roof on Palm Sunday triumphantly. How you gonna be triumphant and you have to get off into a corner and weep over the city because you know it's getting ready to be wiped out because they don't know the time of their visitation. How you gonna make a triumphant entry and you want a donkey? How you gonna make a triumphant entry and
if you wanna get up, get up!
Suffering servant. No, no, he came to humble himself and to be obedient unto death, even the death.
Press it on his word.
Triumphal entry, Jesus, after I spoil principalities and power, after I defeat sin, death, hell, and the grave, after I shed my blood on Calvary, after I wrestle with principalities and power and spiritual wickedness in high places, then I'm going to make a triumph over the deep. But what does that really imply? Well, Bishop, well, here's what he's saying. Defeated my enemies. I got them under my control. The blood of Jesus.
like 80 RPMs. Turn it
until a spear goes in his side. I'm not anointing until a So
get it flat. Believe it. Ride on it. Spend a churches all over the world. I want you to believe. Hold on to that word that our studios will be open soon. We will meet again at our conferences. We will meet again all over the world. Everyone that missed the conference that was coming in May in Miami, we will meet again. To my sister Karen, I'll see you again. Even if me and my husband has to bring Rejuvenate there to Australia with you. To all my friends, Sarah, you're my new friend, I follow you. I may see you soon over in Europe somewhere. To my friends all over, I want you to believe, trust that our spinning studios will open again. We'll get to ride together again. We will have all our studios filled with clients, our overabundance of healing through our studios. But right now, Jesus is going to go to work. He's going to go to work. He's going to work. So I want you guys to know that it's going to be okay. We will be healed. Those that are suffering from that nasty virus, you are healed. You are healed. You are healed. Hallelujah. To my friend Trina, Joyce, Tim, DJ, Corey, DST, Jazzy Jack. To my friend Bob the Entertainer, that lost his life. To everyone. Who? To April, my sister-in-law. I want to tell you, each and every one of y'all out there, you are healed. You are healed. You are healed. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Just say thank you. Just say thank you. All over the world. Say thank you. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Oh, yes. Hold on. Preacher, pastor, bishop, press on. I see DJ Jazzy Jeff on yesterday. Looks great. He feels great. Wonderful. To everybody that may be sickened, if you're scared, don't be scared no more. Jesus got your back. So just hold on to this word. God will. He will give us this victory. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Yes, Lord. Say yes. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. Turn your gears down a little. Now, this time in the service is for you all over the world. If you're on your bike, keep it at about 75 and above. To everyone else out there, I want you to look in your mirror. If you don't have a mirror near you, I want you to feel that you're looking in a mirror. And I want you just to tap your feet, raise your hands, clap your hands, and say, I thank you. That's it. It's over. Thank you. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, yes. You've been riding on this word. You're still riding on this word. And I want you to trust and believe in yourself. Everybody on Facebook Live, Venmo, I want you to say yes. Yes. Say yes. Oh, yeah. has been amazing this morning, but it ain't over. Oh yeah. Woo! Oh yeah. Hallelujah. 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 How you doing? How y'all doing? Woo! How you doing? Woo! There was someone calling my phone. Karen, you're interrupting my spirit. I'll call you later. Woo! Hallelujah. Bishop J.Louis Felton was amazing. Give him some hearts. All over the world, give him some hearts. You rode to Mt.Airy Church of God in Christ this morning, from morning to afternoon. Hallelujah. Let me see them hearts. Woo, I see ya. Press that button. Show my bishop you loved it. This word just this morning. Press it. Press it 4 or 5 times. Woo! Press it. I see you. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. Turn your ears down low. Turn them down low. Thank you. Thank you. I'm thankful that you guys chose to ride with us this Sunday morning into our afternoon spin. We do this each and every Sunday. This is our medicine. We're not on any medications. We're just on spinning, which is winning, and this word. All our medication we have. We have 2 things, and most of all, we have each other, and we have you guys. I thank you. I thank you. We're going to listen to Bishop's last words. We thank you.
For the blood of Jesus.
Woo, slowing your legs down.
The blood of Jesus that transforms the nation. We thank you.
We thank you. We thank you, Bishop. We thank you, Bishop J. Louis Felton, for this wonderful ride. Every pain that you may have out there is gone. Leave it. Trust in yourself. Trust that the Lord will lead you and guide you.
We love you.
We do love you. We love you. So I hope you guys enjoyed as we're going to start winding down recovery. We're just on a flat road to the spinners out there.
The shutdown order.
Oh.
There will be no congregants.
Oh, yeah.
No provisions in the pews.
All right.
But this house is filled with the glory of God. This place is filled.
Yes.
With the majesty of God.
This is our spinning studios, my hair salon and spa. It's filled with people.
This place. Then God connect us through the Holy Spirit.
Oh, yes.
Join us.
Oh, yes. Live stream.
Those who do this telecast.
Oh, yes.
Those who heard the radio broadcast. Those who buy the CD or DVD.
Yes.
Let the same glory rise up within him.
Yes, Lord.
With every bow down here, be with the book of God.
Slowing your legs down. Hands, head, or back is bowed.
Let souls be delivered and set free. Let backsliders be reclaimed.
guys. But now it's time to give.
We have released our faith for a minute.
You know, all of your homes have to pay electric bills and bills. So if you want to sow a seed to Mt.Airy, Church of God in Christ, this is the time in the service that you shall open your hearts, your wallets.
1-855
servant leader, LDR.
Mt.AiryCoaching.com.
Now, I don't know about you guys, but this experience has been amazing. So I hope you're right when this word was amazing. But it has been amazing for me and my husband and our quarantine spinning studio. So we give you this word each and every Sunday, God willing. God has blessed us to be able to be his servant on Sunday through Sunday. Because we're here every day. Open conversation is tomorrow, spin 8:15. You guys can Google us, Rejuvenate Fitness DA. We have Senior Fit for all my seniors out there. You're ready to work out. Get ready. Seniors. We have Fat Burning class. Kickboxing Tuesday. Y'all gonna get ready. So we have Indoor Aqua. Now check that class out. To all my Aqua people, come check your girl out. Google us, Rejuvenate Fitness, PA. This is the time that we need you guys to sow a seed into Mt.Airy for giving us such a blessing word. And then reach us tomorrow at 8:30, right here, spinning with a twist. Me and my husband, Mark, is here on Monday morning. My wingman. So, I need you guys to come support us tomorrow, but please sow that seed to Mt.Airy, Church of God in Christ. He was amazing just this morning. But we know, one thing that we know as Christians, if you're whatever religion, I don't know, because I have multi religions as friends with multiple religions, and I love each and every one of them the same. But we're asking you to sow a seed into Mt.Airy Church of God in Christ just this morning. Reach in your hearts with everything. We accept everything. $1 to $1,000 plus dollars. So if you're blessed enough to sow that seed, sow it to Mt.Airy Church of God in Christ this morning. And then we'll see you back on Monday to Rejuvenate Navarro. So you have to register before 8:15, because we start at 8:15. So please register. Open conversation. 12 o'clock. Senior Fit. So, I want to thank you guys today. Schedule in class, and you got to press classes.
All right,
guys.
Because every country.
you feel? We would like to say, God bless you.